Hello everybody and welcome to the moving vlogs. Not sure how many of them there's going to be. I'm just going to film as much as I can. There might be several, might not be like a weekly vlog because I might have so much footage. Who knows? I mean, you'll know at the time that you're watching this because I'll have edited it all, but at this moment in time, I don't know. But today is Sunday and we are not in focus. Now we're in focus. Today's Sunday and it is packing day. We've got two solid days of packing, Sunday, Monday. I go down on Tuesday to pick the keys up and then the removals van comes on Wednesday morning and Mum's also coming down on Wednesday to help me unpack. But today and tomorrow are intense days. I've also got to go into town today to develop some film, my film from Tropea. So yeah, we have a lot to do. Let's just go and speak to the team. It's a team of two today because teamwork does often make the dream work, doesn't it?
This is going to be a dream.
It's not going to be a dream.
No, the test today will be that we don't fall out.
We will fall out.
No, we're not going to fall out. Can't afford to fall out.
How are you feeling about it all?
I just need to get on, really.
Yeah.
I want to get on.
Should we make a coffee?
Okay, that's not getting on though, but no, yes.
Yeah, but I think you need another coffee.
And what about Daphne?
Oh, I don't want to get her.
Right, what time are you going to leave?
Oh, the film place probably won't open till 11.
Okay. Okay, go put the coffee on, and when you go into town, I'll go and get her.
Okay, well, I'll go into town for 11, say, then.
So you're leaving here after driving?
I'm going to drive because I'm going to go to John Lewis.
Yes, no, that's fine.
So we're also going to John Lewis today to get some homeware things. I've not got anything. Well, I have got some things, but I haven't got all the, like, cutlery, plates, everything like that. I need to get towels, bedding, that all needs to be bought, so we're doing that today. Before I make the coffee, today's moving outfit is very old Uniqlo shirt, one of my favourite shirts, BDG jeans, high top Converse, moving chic. Rolls from Italy. I'm very excited about them. Drop that off, take an hour to be developed. Within that hour, I'm not going to leave John Lewis. I'm doing a little bit of online shopping. And John Lewis have such an impressive range that they seem to have the cheapest options for most things, really, even though it's a posh shop. So there's a big one in Leeds, so I'm going to go there and buy a heck of a lot of stuff. Things like a TV. Oh, could I care any less about a TV? I need to have one because I watch it. How am I going to watch Buffy? But I don't want to have to buy one. It's how boring. I'd rather buy shoes than a TV. Got a basket full of towels. Onto bedding, just want white bedding. Don't get white towels because I use like fake tan and always end up with eye makeup on a towel somehow. Mum goes mad. But I'd love a white fluffy towel, but it wouldn't stay white for long. Sheets though, I can go for white sheets. Momentarily abandoned bedding, it was overwhelming. Might check the white company. Do I need an ironing board now or can it wait? Ideally I'd never iron, but I ought to get an ironing board. Maybe not now. Oh, maybe I should just go now. This is really difficult. I want one of these. Mum describes this life-changing. Okay guys, I've left John Lewis, just done HomeSense. I'm going to show you everything that I've got when I get home rather than doing it on the go. But everything is going well. There's only a few things I'm missing which I'll get tomorrow. And now I'm just going to go to the White Company and get some bedding. And then I've got like a few beauty bits and bobs to pick up from John Lewis. I left my hair straight in Italy, which is like the last thing I need to spend money on right now, but anyway, here we are. So yeah, nearly done, then home time. So I've just got back. Show you what I got. Most of it's really boring, but I am gonna show you like everything. We're gonna be thorough about this. Where should I put you? Let's put you. Okay, we're gonna come from this angle. Or from HomeSense, a sieve. I wasn't kidding when I said this wasn't exciting. I also bought a knife block, Sabatier, if you're interested. There we go. In here we also have a bottle opener, some scissors, and a potato peeler. Well, not just potatoes actually, you can peel whatever you fancy with it, an all-purpose peeler. So that was HomeSense, deeply exciting. We bought the exact same espresso coffee machine that we have in Manchester. I bought a TV, a 40-inch one, because I hate it when TVs are the focus in a room. I really, really hate it. So I never want a big TV. I don't watch that much TV anyway. So 40-inch, I feel like, is a good size. Maybe it's going to look tiny when it's there. We'll see. Some pans from John Lewis. So in the kitchen, as you'll see tomorrow, it's got like a rail above the countertop to hang pans on. So I bought some like silver, kind of see there, some silver matching ones. That's so loud. I also bought some towels. This kind of putty colour. As I was saying, I get makeup on white stuff. Treating myself to a Le Creuset. What the heck is this called? Oven mitt. It's like the one that we had in Manchester. It was really good. A dishcloth, a cheese grater, some cleaning cloths. The one thing that I couldn't get because they sold out was a vacuum cleaner. I'm gonna get one of those like cordless Dyson ones. I showed you, I think. Anyway, they sold out, so I couldn't get that. What else? Anyway, I just got some like normal white, one full set of white bedding, one full set of just off-white cream, just for a bit of difference. And I think that was it. I feel like I've kind of broken the back of stuff that I'm gonna urgently need, but most of the stuff I'll remember I need it when I go to cook something and think I haven't got a bowl, things like that. So feeling like I've got most of it. I need to do another trip out tomorrow and get like the Hoover, a hammer, things that I can hang photos with when I get there, stuff like that, but it has been successful. Now, I see all these boxes packed up, ready for clothes. This is the main bit of what I've got to pack up. Good morning, guys. So it's packing day two today, basically. You know, yesterday when I was vlogging, I was like, I don't know where the bedding is, but it'll be somewhere. Still in John Lewis. I didn't check. There's so many bags because you like shop around and then they send it down to the collection point. There's so many bags that I didn't check in them all, and that one hadn't made it down there yet. So we're trying to sort that out today. Mum's on the phone to them now, and I am listening to Harry Styles and sorting out shoes. Being super brutal with what I'm taking. I've done pretty well with all the clothes. I've gone through all the clothes. Today's shoes and like makeup. I don't really have that much makeup. And then stuff, miscellaneous stuff. Shoes first. Complaining about the same things, not watching where we're going, ending up 50 somehow with nothing. No, don't listen to what they say. Temperatures rising and no one knows. Hide behind the money, that's the way it goes. The world could be on fire and we wouldn't know. And so it goes another day here, passing by. I saw it waving from the window. Could you save me? Keep taking time, taking your time, but there's no time. We've come out to Astor Living in Argos to get boring things like irons and ironing boards. It's only 10:30 and I've already lost the will to live today. It's gonna be a long day. August trip complete.
Yes.
We now have, this is everything we bought just now, a vacuum cleaner, one of those cordless Dyson ones. They're very good, apparently.
Yes.
Lindsay has one as well.
They're very good. Yeah,
she said it changed her life. A duvet. More packing boxes.
Not so good.
Some weighing scales for like kitchen ones, not human ones. Why can't I remember a single thing that's just happened?
An iron.
An ironing board. Mum made me buy an expensive one.
I bought it.
Oh, okay, fair enough, actually, you did, didn't you? Oh, thank you.
It's okay.
I didn't even realise that.
I didn't pay you.
Thank you. No, well, I'm pleased about that, actually, because I didn't want a £50 ironing board. Thank you. A big frying pan. Why is it so hard to remember? This has only been like half an hour ago.
A whisk. A knife. And a garlic press
and some mixing bowls. Three mixing bowls.
There you go. It's all rushing back now.
There was something else in Argos, was there not?
Yes, there were a number of things in Argos.
We have done them all.
Yeah.
Some hangers. And oh, I said iron.
Did I?
A mattress topper.
Mattress topper.
There we go. That's everything. Yeah. Bye. Check in later. Goodbye. People love it though. I love watching stuff like this and it's so not exciting. That's why it's so thrilling. We've just come into Ilkley to get something to eat because packing is complete. I'll show you the boxes when we get back in the garage. We didn't fall out. We did really well. So we're going to eat. I've got work to do, which is killer. And then we might watch Notting Hill tonight.
Yes, that'd be nice.
Seeing as that's where I'm going.
Yes.
I've not seen that in so long as well. So we'll watch that. Sounds like a plan. First food, I'm starving. Everything's all packed up. All these boxes. Ah, the ironing board that Mum bought me. Posh ironing board. That will become a thing now every time I use it. All of this stuff. How exciting. Just about to get the train to Leeds, then get on the train to London. One way though. What's the matter?
It might not speak to me.
Oh, right. Yeah, not a return this time around. Hi, from my flat in London. I look and feel like I've been dragged through a hedge backwards. Everything's gone relatively smoothly. Some things are still here that I had asked them to take out. Some things haven't been done that they said they were going to do. Things like that. But I've spoken to the agent and it's going to be sorted. I'm just going to be chilled with it because it's not the end of the world and there's nothing I can do about it right now apart from speak to the agent, which I've done. So, let's do an empty tour. Right, start from the front door. Okay, so this is the main space. The sofa I asked them to leave. Basically, the challenge here, one which I'm actually really looking forward to taking on, is making this space work as a living space and an office, but somehow having the two feeling separate from one another. And I think I'm going to have to do it by the clever placement of furniture, which is going to take some trial and error and some playing around, and I haven't even begun to fully decide which end of the room I'd want to be like the living area and which end I'd want to be the desk area. Initially I'd thought the back end is the desk area, but the TV connection's in that corner, so that might restrict things a bit, but we'll see. Anyway, this is the space. Some of the things that made me really fall in love with this place was the damp. I mean, just kidding. That's one of the things that they're gonna be painting over. But yeah, some of the things that I really loved were like these radiators. The backs of the doors are all mirrored with ironwork on, which reminded me of my Uncle Luigi's architecture. The fireplace and things, I mean, like these bits and bobs here, I don't want this mirror. This is gonna go, don't want this mirror here. But yeah, so this is the main living space, okay? Kitchen's here, I've just made myself a cup of tea. Can't work out how to turn the fridge on, we're gonna jump that bridge in a second. Got a dishwasher, got a sink, a very, very lovely sink actually with a teaspoon in it because I've just made a cup of tea. I'm gonna hang all my pots and pans there. probably have glasses there maybe. I'm oddly into glassware, it's a weird thing. And then the bedroom with an ironing board in it. So this isn't super big, this is like gonna fit a bed, haven't even got bedside tables yet, but a bed, bedside tables, wardrobe, somewhere I've gotta put my shoes, somewhere I've gotta fit a 6 foot rail or two worth of clothes. We're gonna also jump that bridge when we get to it. And then in here is the bathroom. This, I didn't want them to be here, but it's got a nice sink, an amazing freestanding bath with a big shower head, fancy old toilet. So yeah, so it's not huge. I mean, the living space I think is pretty huge. I'm really excited to have my stuff in it, to get the rugs on the floor and things like that tomorrow. It's going to be a different place by the end of tomorrow. I know it's going to feel so different. And things like the walls are quite marked and stuff, but because there's nothing in it now, it really is. I keep looking at them all thinking that's going to really bug me, but I think once I've got my pictures up and everything like that, then it's not going to be as noticeable. But yeah, I feel quite stressed. I'm quite overwhelmed, but also I'm in here. I don't feel like this has all happened, is how I feel, but yeah. Here I am. I'm just gonna drink my cup of tea, go through some emails. Lynn's and James, her boyfriend, are coming around for a floor picnic. We're gonna eat, order something in. I'm not getting any food, but eat on the floor. So that'd be really nice. There's guests here. What do you think so far?
Oh, it's class, isn't it? Can't be doing some work outside.
She's just fallen up the stairs twice. That's the bedroom.
Oh.
They left me an ironing board.
Chandelier in every room.
I know, we need to learn how to spell it.
Your hair's nice, by the way. Has it gone light in the sun?
I don't think it has.
Well, you look very nice. I can see all your freckles.
Oh, really? I've got spots as well. So there's stuff that needs to go, and we'll talk about it all anyway.
Oh, is it? Oh, it's so nice.
It's nice and light.
It's so good.
Isn't it?
Oh, it's class.
Ordered our delivery room.
It's a floor picnic.
Floor picnic, floor picnic. Lindsay's just left, so I'm just running myself a bath. Slowly. It's not the most powerful water, so this could take a few weeks, but that's fine. I bought today some Aesop body cleanser because I felt fancy. Some Aesop hand wash, which it is obviously fancy, but it is extremely posh of me, but I've gotten to the point where this is an essential in my life. It is the best hand wash ever. It brings me literal joy when I use it. The smell's amazing. And also this candle, which is very lovely. This is ridiculous. I need to find a way to get this having a bit more oomph behind it. Hi guys, just future me checking in to say I'm going to end this section of the moving vlogs here. And then on Wednesday, part two, where I start moving all my stuff in, we'll go, because I had so much footage that it meant to split them into two, that would be like 20 minutes each rather than have one insanely long one. So, hope you've enjoyed this one. Thank you so much for watching, and the next one will be with you in a couple of days.